Well, you've heard about how smartphones are interfering with our sleep, our relationships, our attention spans, our self-esteem. Ugh. But now there's evidence that they could be shortening your life.
So let's just throw them away, right? Let's get to medical reporter Dr. Mike Siriano, live in the big Philly. Good to see you, Mike. How you doing, buddy?
You know, I'm streaming you, and you guys look fantastic.
Well, thank you.
Oh, my thank God. You.
It's the Mark and Abby. Holy
I appreciate
cow.
That.
Well, it's good that you're finally
tuned in. I'm going to give you T-shirts that say Body by Dr. Mike, and you're going to wear it all around campus.
Love it. Love it.
Yes.
Which reminds me, I've got a little ache I need you to look at. Anyway, let's get back to the cell phones.
Anyway.
Why are we so addicted to our phones?
Well, these little devices, while being very cool and very convenient and part of everyone's life now, they have some effects on brain biochemistry. Number one, when you get on this phone, it has effects on dopamine, which is a neurotransmitter, if you will, and it is responsible for pleasure and part of the brain that leads to addiction. So that's number one. This new data looks at the fact that it also releases cortisol. So when you get all excited and you're on the phone looking at your social media or whatever, you release cortisol. Now, cortisol is a stress hormone, and when we were being attacked or chased by a tiger back in the day, it was a good thing because it raised your blood sugar, made your blood pressure go up, heart rate go up, and you could run faster. But now, for the most part, there's no tigers around, and so we just have high blood pressure, and we have a faster heart rate, and it damages the blood vessels, leading to an increased risk of stroke and heart attack.
I get chased by a cougar every once in a while. Does that count?
No. I know, Mike. Dr. Mike, you and I, man. I hear you.
It's hard. It's hard to shut me up, and you just silenced me, Mark. I mean...
All right. How do you break the cycle?
Right.
How do you?
Right.
How do we get out of this live shot?
it takes discipline. It takes discipline. You need to say, look, number one, and what I do with my kids and my family, no electronics at the dinner table. That's number one. Number two, it's just like every other addictive thing in the world. You have to have discipline, and you have to say, look, I don't want to do this all day long. And it's been my experience, Mark and Abby, that the bottom line is young people, because they're so it's part of their body, the cell phone. They don't know how to interact on a personal level. And so you can't communicate anymore with people. And so you need to be able to be, you have to be human. Remember the over in New Jersey, the blimp, you know, the Zeppelin?
Right.
Oh, the humanity. You need to have humanity. All right, and so what are we doing here? We need to have interaction with our fellow human beings. Put the cell phone down.
There you go, my brother. Preach it.
Love it.
Of course, he's referencing the Hindenburg back for those who were.
That's it. The Hindenburg, right.
Yes.
Lakehurst. Not far.
Mike, thank you so much. I mean, Dr. Mike. And hope you enjoyed us as much as you do Mike and Alex there at our Fox station in Philly. So.
Well, they're my patients. I'm expecting you two to be my patients someday.
That's quite a commute. Thanks, Dr. Mike.
That'd be a long rubber glove.
That's all right. That's all right.
We'll make it work.
Squared away.
I like it.
All right. Ciao.
I love you both. You're great. You're a lot of fun.
We love you too, Dr. Mike.